In this video, you learn 5 Power BI visuals you probably didn't know. So let's get into it. In number 5, we've got a decomposition tree, which I know sounds quite fancy, but it's really just to understand the root cause of a number. So you can see over here that we've got this data set, which you can download for free in the video description. So we're gonna head over to the report view. From here, what we're gonna wanna add is the decomposition tree right over here. Let me quickly resize that. Here, let's suppose that our manager wants us to dig deeper into the sales by geography. So for this, we're gonna wanna analyze the sales. So the total sales here, I'm just gonna drag across. And then we want it to be explained by the geography. So we might add things like the region. We could also add the state here. And finally, we can add the city. So with those three, we should get a good explanation for the revenue. So over here, we've got the total sales. And now what we wanna do here is expand on it. So we can click the plus sign. So the high value and the low value are actually the AI features in Power BI. And the high value is gonna explain why the numbers are high. So if we click on high value, we'll see in this scenario, which states are contributing or which regions first. So you can see, it seems like the West is the number one contributor. If we click on that plus sign again, we go for the high value. Here, we're gonna start to see, okay, that the state of California seems to be the strongest contributor. And we can even break that down further, hitting high value again. And now we're gonna see the breakdown by city. Similarly, instead of looking at the West, let's suppose we're interested in the South this time. We can just click on that and we're gonna get that full breakdown dynamically as well. Next up, we've got the key influencers, which, similar to the decomposition tree, allows you to understand the key drivers to a metric. So first, we're gonna go ahead and select the key influencers, which is this icon over here. And let me quickly resize that. And let's suppose our manager wants to know what's driving our sales to increase. So for that, we wanna analyze the total sales again. And this time around, we could put some variables that we think could be contributing. Like for example, we can select the region. We could also try to select the price per unit and see how that's affecting it. Maybe a higher price means more revenue for us. For this, instead of the sum, I'm just gonna click on that arrow sign and change it to the average price. And you can see that Power BI is gonna automatically populate some kind of a visual where it says what influences total sales to increase or decrease. We have that option. In this case, it's to increase. And it seems here like when the region is the Southeast, the average of total sales seems to increase by about 1,000. Similarly, with the price per unit, if we click on that, we'll see the different visual here. And it seems like as the price per unit goes up, the average total sales also increases. So maybe it's worth considering that as well. And if you're liking these visuals and you want to learn more, you can check out our brand new Power BI for Business Analytics course. In our all-inclusive curriculum, we start with data cleaning and transformation using Power Query. Then we get into data visualization tools, followed by DAX or data analysis expressions, which is what you use to build formulas in Power BI. Then to simulate real work scenarios, we'll go over 2 extensive case studies. One will focus on building a profit and loss dashboard from scratch on Nike, while the other will focus on visualizing McDonald's European restaurant operations. Currently, 97% of Fortune 500 companies use Power BI. So if you're looking to invest in yourself, make sure you check out the link in the description below. All right, back to visuals. Next up, in number 3, we've got a line chart with bookmarks. And you're probably wondering what that means, so let me show you. Over here, first, what we're gonna do is just insert a normal line chart. Let me resize that. Here, we can add something like the total sales, and we can put those by the dates. You can see right now that this is on a daily basis, but if we click these arrows over here, you can see there's that drill up that allows us to break it down into monthly and then further into quarterly. Now, it would be nice to have some kind of a slicer down over here where we can choose quarter, by month, or by day. Now that's when the bookmarks are gonna come handy for us. So for it, we're just gonna head over to the View tab. Then we're gonna go over to Bookmarks. So just click on that, and we're gonna add 3 bookmarks here. Let me go ahead and fast forward how I relabel them. Alright, so I've updated them to quarter, month, and day. For the quarter one, it's fine as is. Right now we're seeing it in quarters. So we're gonna go to this dropdown over here and hit on update. Then we're just gonna go down one here to the month. And then we're gonna go to the month dropdown under bookmark and hit on update. And the same thing goes with the day. So we'll go drop down by one. Under day here, we're gonna click on the dropdown and hit on update. Great. Now that we have those three, we just need to add the buttons. So we're gonna head over to insert, under buttons. These buttons are gonna be based on the bookmarks. So all the way at the bottom, you'll find the bookmark navigator option, which is the one that we're gonna wanna select. Great. Now you can see over here that we have the three options right there. And if you wanna activate them, you just hit control and click, and same thing here. And you can see how that's all dynamic. A quick design tip to improve this visual is simply to head over to style here and add a shadow. So when we scroll down, you'll find the option for a shadow. So just click on that and you can see that it looks a lot more sleek there. In number two, we've got a line chart with target areas. And this makes sense if you want to see where your numbers are in relation to a target. To show you this, we'll first create a simple line chart. And let's suppose that this time we go for the unit sold and we go by date. So by month more specifically, I'm just gonna go inside this dropdown and just hit on only the month. Let me resize that. So right now this looks like a simple line chart. So what we wanna do is head over to the search bar here, the add further analysis icon. And within it, we're gonna go towards the bottom where it says error bars. Here under options, first we wanna activate it. And you can see that we've got an upper bound and a lower bound. These are going to be the upper range and the lower range that we want our figures to be in. So what we're going to have to do is create new measures, which are going to allow us to specify what our numbers are for the upper and the lower bound. Now for this, we're going to head over to home, then go to new measure. And here we're going to be able to specify that we want, say, an upper bound of say 1.5 million. And I'm just gonna hit on enter there. And you can see right now that we have that upper bound. So we're simply gonna drag and drop it to the upper bound area. And now we want a lower bound. So I'm just gonna hit on new measure again. This time this is gonna be the lower bound. And let's make it equal to 1.3 million. And I'm just gonna hit enter there as well. Once we have those, then I'm gonna drag the lower bound in as well. You can see right now this isn't looking too great, so let's do a few changes. First, we're just gonna deactivate the bar, and then we're gonna activate the error band. And now we can see very clearly that this is the range we should be in for the quantity sold, and these numbers are too high, and these are too low. Maybe that could affect our supply chain. Finally, in number one, we've got the calendar visual, which allows us to see the sales by day, see if there's maybe a trend on weekends or on certain work days. Now for this, it's actually not part of the visualizations here. Instead, we're gonna go to this dropdown right here and go to get more visuals. This is gonna open a whole new array of Power BI visuals. You can kind of see it like their marketplace. And I'm just gonna look up here on the search bar for calendar. And don't worry, this is all completely free right now. So I'm just gonna click on that one. And once it loads up, I'm just gonna hit on add. Let's hit okay. And you can find it right over here as this new icon. So let's just go and tick on that. And I'm just gonna make that bigger. Then for the date field, we're just gonna select the invoice date. And then let's suppose that we wanna see the sale breakdown. So the sales by day, you can start to see the labels over here. And don't worry, this still needs a bit of work. So let's get into that. Under format your visual, first thing we wanna do here is increase the size of the labels. So instead of a size 8 down over here, we could go with something like a 15. Now we can see the sales numbers a lot better. Then we can add some conditional formatting so we see what's a high or a low number. For that, we'll go over to the colors right above. And for a minimum, let's say we go with a white color. And then for the maximum, we could go with something like a red. And now you can see what that's looking like. Right now, this visual isn't dynamic. It's only for January 2021. So to make it dynamic, we could add a slicer. So let's deselect out of this chart first, and then click on this icon here, which is the slicer icon. Specifically, we want to see the monthly breakdown here. So I'm just going to drag the month and add it over to the fields here. And now we can see that we have this drop down to the side. Now, if I want to change this, say to the month of February, you can see that all the data is going to dynamically update. Same thing with any other month. For more on Power BI, check out this video over here, or check out this link to take our Power BI course. Hit the like and that subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next one.